Hi everyone, this is T. Dinesh Kumar. In this video, I am going to explain you about the global position system based atmospheric occultation. The outline of this presentation is measurements made using GPS signals, the basics of GPS radio occultation, data availability, observations being considered, the limiting factors for atmospheric occultation, and the conclusion towards that. The measurements which are being made using the GPS signals are the GPS radio occultation, which is the basic profile information where a GPS signal will be present and which is being measured by the GPS receiver placed on the satellite. So what are the information that can be measured is that it can measure the wind speed information from a scattered signal, so which is the first diagram. So the second is that the ground based GPS, so the GPS receiver will be placed on the earth's surface, and based upon that the informations can be measured, whatever the antenna transmits. Depending upon the application, it will vary. So third one is the wind speed information from the scattered signal, so where two satellites which are being placed in space will monitor or will measure the atmospheric informations. The basic GPS radio occultation physics is based upon the refractive index, where speed of an electromagnetic wave in a vacuum divided by the speed through the medium, n is equal to c by v, and it also follows the Snell's law of refraction, n1 sin I1 is equal to n2 sin I2. So where I1 is your incident, I2 is your refracted, and the medium will be having refractive index n2 greater than n1. The radio occultation measures have been used to study planetary atmospheres, for example the Mars and Venus, since the 1960s. It is an active technique that the parts of the radio signals are bent by the refractive index gradients in the atmosphere. So using this, the radio occultation measurements are being done. The use of radio occultation measurements in the Earth's atmosphere was originally proposed in 1965, but required the advent of the GPS constellation of satellites to provide a suitable source of radio signals. The use of GPS signals discussed at the Jet Propulsion Laboratory in late 1980s made the proof of the concept of GPS or MET, which demonstrated the useful temperature information could be derived from the GPS RO occultations. So the basic idea is that the GPS satellites are primarily a tool for positioning and navigation. These satellites emit radio signals at L1 band of 1.5754 GHz and L2 band, which is 1.2276 GHz. Approximately the wavelength would be 20 cm. So the GPS signal velocity is modified in the atmosphere and neutral atmosphere because the refractive index is not always unity, and the path is bent because of gradients in the refractive index. So the GPS RO based is used on analyzing the bending caused by the neutral atmosphere along ray paths between a GPS satellite and a receiver placed on a LEO orbits, low earth orbiting satellites. So the GPS RO geometry is that earth is being present, atmosphere, the neutral atmosphere, and the ionosphere. We have satellites in different positioning which are obtained from the occulting LEO satellites and the occulting GPS satellites. So the data are being obtained from these accessions. So the time delay and the bend angle provide the density versus its altitude. Setting occultation: as the low earth orbiting moves behind the earth, we obtain a profile of bending angles A as a function of the impact factor alpha. So the impact factor parameter is the distance of closest approach for the straight line path, which is directly analogous to angular moment of a particle. The GPS RO characteristics: is that it should have a good vertical resolution. Around 70% of the bending occurs over in a distance of approximately 450 km section of ray path, centered on the tangent point, which is the point closest to the surface. So it has a broad horizontal weighting function with a Gaussian shape to first order. All weather capability. So the RO occultation is not affected by cloud or rain or fog. So this would be a best system to measure the atmospheres. So the bending is approximately 1 to 2 degrees at the surface, falling exponentially with height. So the scale height of the decay is approximately the density scale height. So a profile of bending angles approximately 60 km tangent height to the surface takes about 2 minutes. So the tangent point drifts in the horizontal by approximately 200 km during the measurement. The ray optics processing of the GPS based RO observations do not require measure temperatures or ray bending directly. So the GPS receiver on the LEO satellites measures a time series of phase delays with the function f of I minus 1, f of I plus 1 at the two different GPS frequencies, so which is L1 band and L2 band. The phase delays are calibrated to remove special and general relativistic effects to remove the GPS and LEO clock errors. So the differencing was given by Hudge et al. In 2002, which calculates the excess phase delays and removes straight line paths of the function d of f of I. So a time series of Doppler shifts at L1 and L2 can be calculated by differentiating the excess phase delays with respect to time. So the processing of the GPS RO observations can be obtained by the ray bending caused by gradients in the atmosphere and ionosphere, modifying the L1 and L2 Doppler values, but deriving the bending angles from the Doppler values is an ill-posed problem. So an infinite set of bending angles could produce the Doppler. So you can see the diagram, a LEO low earth orbiting satellite is being placed. So from that we have the radius r, which is measured from the center of the earth with an angle phi. So the problem made well posed by assuming the impact factor or the impact parameter is given by a is equal to nr sin phi. So n is the refractive index, a is the parameter. So this will be similar at both the satellites. So given accurate position and velocity estimates for the satellites and making the impact parameter assumption, the bending angle A and impact parameter value can be derived simultaneously from the Doppler shift. So Doppler shift plays a major role in the radio calculations. So next is the ionospheric correction. We have to isolate the atmospheric component of a bending angle. The ionosphere is dispersive, and so we can take a linear combination of both the L1 band and L2 band's bending angles to obtain the corrected bending angle. So the corrected bending angle can be obtained by alpha of A, C of alpha L1 of A minus C minus 1 alpha of L2 of A. So where C is a constant given in terms of L1 and L2 frequencies. So this can be obtained by this formula. C is equal to FL1 square divided by FL1 the whole square minus FL2 the whole square. FL1 is your frequency of L1 band, FL2 is the frequency of the L2 band. So how good is the correction? Does it introduce time varying bias that with solar cycle? The answer is yes. The retrieve temperatures will be sensitive to this. Deriving the refractive index profiles is a major factor. So assuming spherical symmetry, the ionospheric corrected bending angle can be written as alpha of A is equal to minus 2A with the limits of A to infinity, differentiation of ln n divided by dx divided by square root of x square minus a square into dx. So where alpha of A is a corrected bending angle as a function of impact parameter, x is a constant variable where x is equal to n into r, refractive index into radius. So we use an Albert transform to derive the refractive index profile. So note that n of x is equal to exponential of 1 by pi a to infinity alpha of a square root of a square minus x square into d a. So where This limit, the upper limit of the integral, is an prior information need to explore it towards infinity. The example of an amplitude or the receiver, we have amplitude versus SLTA, which is your basically a time measurement approximately with respect to kilometers. You can see the atmospheric defocusing, so which varies from minus 200 to 50. So I can see that phi A and phi B, phi times of A, phi times of B, so the amplitude of variation. Next is the data availability. The proof of concept of GPS / MET mission in 1996 was a major success, which led to a number of missions of opportunity, proposals for a constellation of a LEO satellites, and first dedicated operational instruments. So the current status is that missions of opportunity, GRACE A or B, or TerraSAR X and Tandem X, is the current status. The cosmic constellation of 6 LEO satellites was launched in 2006, which is originally formed. Now this provides approximately 800 to 900 occultations per day at a peak of 2200 at peak. The GRAS instruments on METOP A and METOP B provides approximately 1300 measurements per day. So the GRAS is the only fully operational instrument. The GRAS on METOP B has been assimilated since May 21, 2013. Why are GPS RO useful for NWP, given that we already have millions of radiance measurements? GPS RO complements the radiances, so the observations that are useful if they provide new information. So this is the reason that is being done. So the RO can be assimilated without bias correction. They are good for highlighting model errors or biases. Most other satellite observations require bias correction to the model. The GPS RO measurements anchor the bias correction of radiance measurements. Importance of anchor measurements in weak constraint, 4D variants, climate or reanalysis applications. The GPS RO or the LIMS sounders in general have sharper weighting functions in the vertical and therefore have good vertical resolution properties. The GPS based RO measurements can see vertical structures that are in null space of the satellite radiances. Use of GPS RO in NWP. So NWP centers assimilate either bending angle or refractivity. The classical retrieval is very useful for understanding the basic physics of the measurement, but not recommended for use in NWP. So the pre-processing steps and the prior information required to retrieve temperature complicate the errors. We can test the one-dimensional bending angle and refractivity observation operators in 1D variance retrievals to estimate the information content and vertical resolution of the measurements. The GPS also has a null space, so which is the measurement is related to density, which is approximately equal to P over T on your height levels, and this ambiguity measure means that the effect of some temperatures perturbations cannot be measured. Assume two levels separated by Z as shown in the diagram with temperature variations T of Z between them. Now add a positive perturbation del T of Z approximately equal to exponential of Z by H, where H is the density scale height. So I can write it here. So P and T will have an increased at Z, but the P bar T is the same. From this diagram you can see that. So T of Z plus del T of Z, and Z of 2 is equal to Z plus del Z. The density as a function of height is almost unchangeable, so a priori information required to distinguish between these temperature profiles is called the GPS RO null space. The null space measurement, how does a temperature perturbation propagate through the bending angle observation operator, is shown in these two diagrams. We can see the measurement is done for a height of the system with the kilometers measurement and the temperature perturbation measured in kelvins. So temperature measured in kelvins is being given in the values of ratio of minus 10 to plus 10, and the variation of the height of in measured in kilometer from 10 to 60. So I can see the temperature perturbation measured at del x at 0 kelvin, which is approximately at 25 kilometers you get a deviation. So that gives with respect to the bending angle difference, which is in terms of percentage, minus 10 to 10, the bending angle difference in terms of percentages can give approximately that at it is at 40 kilometers around 40 kilometers it assumes the OB errors. The null space arises because the measurements are sensitive to density as a function of height. A priori information is required to split this into T of Z and P of Z. So we can define a temperature perturbation del T of Z, which is approximately exponential of Z by H, which is in the GPS RO null space. Therefore, if the model background contains a bias of this form, the measurement can't see or cannot correct it. So this is an example of NEWP, which is a state. You can see the flow of wind, which is measured at an angles. This is the your longitudinal angle, this is your latitudinal angle. So you can see different parts. So NEP is a place, so how this winds move around a geographical path in this area. Deriving the refractive index profiles is a major factor. So assuming spherical symmetry, the ionospheric corrected bending angle can be written as alpha of A is equal to minus 2A. So the factors limiting the GPS RO impact is that it has been suggested that the use of one-dimensional operators is limiting the GPS RO impact in the troposphere. So the ECMWF now assimilated GPS RO with a 2D operator rather than 1D. So this complicates the forward model also. Conclusion is the GPS RO is a satellite to satellite leap measurement. The outlined basic physics of the GPS RO technique and the classical retrieval is based upon this measurements. The measurements do not require bias correction. The one dimensional observation operators are quite simple. Very good vertical resolution but poor horizontal resolution. Vertical resolution is obtained at a good condition, but at horizontal it's very bad. So also it will be wary of classical temperature retrievals above 35 to 40 kilometers. So they mainly contain a priori information. Information contained studies suggest GPS RO should provide good temperature information in the upper troposphere and lower or middle stratosphere. Operational assimilation and recent OSP supports this. Some impact in troposphere, but other observing systems have bigger impact. The operating of 2D operational implemented at ECMWF improves modeling of observations. References for my presentation is Lange RB, why is the GPS signal so complex in the GPS world? Ben Hoffman, Wellenhoff, H. Lichtinger and J. Collins, GPS theory and practice. Jelinek GPS satellite surveying, John Millicent's. Wells D. et al. Guide to GPS positioning. Kaplan E. Understanding GPS principles and applications. Shaw M. K. Sandhu and Turner, modernization of the global positioning system. Langley R. B. The mathematics of GPS. Conley R. F. Life, after selective availability. B. Parkinson, J. Springer Jr., GPS theory and applications. A. Klusenberg and P. Twinsing, GPS for Geodesy, Ahmed L. Rabani, Introduction to GPS, the Global Positioning System. GPS for Dummies by Joel McNamara, 2008. Understanding GPS Principles and Applications by Elliot Kaplan and Christopher Hegarty. Applications of GPS website, Civilian Applications of GPS website, GPS World website, A Guide to GLONASS website, Official Galileo homepage website, Ice Shelf Tidal Animations website. For any questions, you can comment in my comment box. The GPS RO characteristics is that it should have a good vertical resolution. Around 70% of the bending occurs over